As you know, SAIF is a sector agnostic and stage agnostic fund. So we have been quite busy off late, been making many investments across seed, series A and series B. There have been a bunch of seed investments that we have also led recently, which are not yet announced. As a fund, we are a $350 million fund focused on investing in India. We've been making investments out of our sixth fund, which is just going on. And as a strategy, other fund, we make fewer investments, but we make very, very high conviction investments into the companies and keep a reasonably large amount of money for follow-on investments and keep enough reserves as the company progresses. In particular about seed investments, our key strategy is that we don't want to invest in competing companies. We don't want to invest in two seed companies which are going to compete with each other. So we spend good amount of time with the founders, understanding the thesis, understanding the founders' visions, and then take fewer seed investment bets. Fewer as in not fewer in terms of the volume. Volume is still quite large, but fewer in terms of taking one bet in the sector, one bet in a particular problem statement, and then go all the way out to support those companies over a long time period. You take any of the examples in our portfolio companies. For example, Swiggy was a seed investment that we did. Ours was the first check into the company, and we kept supporting the company as it grew larger. Ours was the first check in Paytm. Ours was the first check in Rivigo. Ours was almost the first seed check in ShareChat as well. So as a fund, we are a fund of people who are very down to earth people, and they do a lot of hard work. Our team is all about hustling, hard work, understanding the sectors to very, very deep levels. All of us at the partner and principal level, we focus on fewer sectors. Everyone has got some specialization area or the other. And what it really allows us is that every partner ends up building a very deep specific knowledge or insights about a particular sector that he or she works on. And that results in us taking investment decisions which are not conventional. So for example, when we invested in ShareChat, there was no geo, there was no chart of vernacular content, there was no chart of video being a big deal in India. But we made that investment because we could understand that this is something that will actually be a common need for the Indian users as the internet ecosystem grows and becomes deeper. And then 2-3 years down the time, a lot of environmental factors changed and the company started suddenly getting a lot of tailwinds. The thing about great companies is that when those companies are founded, quite often they are called as crazy ideas, not really great ideas. But when the external environment changes, then suddenly those companies start getting a lot of tailwinds. So when I joined SAIF about 4 years back, I started our enterprise SaaS B2B practice out here, and we're actually quite bullish on this opportunity because if you look at it, India has got so much of talent in building software, and there are people in India who have worked at global companies and they have been exposed to these deeper problems that that maybe American customer or maybe European or Southeast Asian customer might be facing. And we can actually build software out of India, which is going to be at a reasonably low cost, and actually serve the customer out there. One of the big differentiating factor for Indian B2B SaaS companies is that they have a huge customer focus, customer service mindset. They want to make their customer happy at any cost. And that goes a lot in favor of the Indian enterprise SaaS startups. We are actually quite bullish on this practice. We invested in a company called Goodera, where we led Series B early last year. We invested in a company called Haber, which is a very innovative AI enterprise tech SaaS company. We invested in a logistics SaaS company called FarEye, and we have got a bunch of other companies in the same sector of enterprise SaaS. So we have got a fairly large portfolio in this space and quite bullish going forward as well. I would say more funding is actually definitely good for the ecosystem because it makes the market more deeper. If you look at the entire e-commerce space, if so much money had not come and gotten spent into the system, the market would not probably have been as deep as it is today. It takes money to create markets, and hence when these new funds are coming in, from China, from US, or there's a strategic money coming in, or there are new domestic funds, both micro VC funds as well as funds focused on Series B opening up and investing in startups. I think it is very, very good for the ecosystem. It gives visibility to the entrepreneurs that there are not limited options for me to raise money. I can raise money from a lot of different avenues. It gives that confidence to the founders to actually start up. And I think more number of founders coming in will automatically result in more number of successes going out just by sheer law of numbers. I think the best example of how I being an entrepreneur helps in having a discussion with other entrepreneurs is in terms of being able to get into the lot of depth of the product discussion. So when I talk to the entrepreneurs, I often focus a lot on product demos. I often focus a lot on what are the user insights and problems that they discovered, how are they reflecting in the product, what kind of product features are coming out, how are they solving the customer needs, what kind of analytics is being used to understand the impact of product on the lives of the customers. I think some of these discussions help a lot in building a very good deep connect with the founders, and is actually quite helpful and useful in our conversations.